Skibel.
Before I get to the issues that we're going to discuss, scripturally, I would like to take the time to address three points that Dr. Brown raised. Number one, Dr. Brown opens and closes his presentation with a request and suggestion that I consider a law debate. First time I met Dr. Brown, I said this and I'll repeat it again. I take this presentation seriously. I take our interaction seriously.
Dr. Brown.
I appreciate that he's interacting with me. And I have a responsibility to
Dr.
present in a way that's accurate, that's clear, that serves educational purpose to the best of my ability. I'm a human being, I could make mistakes, but I feel it's my responsibility to give myself the best opportunity that I have to be able to present.
Dr. Brown,
I can't do that under the pressure of responding within so many hours, within a certain time frame. So, no, I'm not going to be doing the right thing.
Further,
Dr. Brown, I will point out that we are actually debating on making a presentation. And Dr. Brown, you are not
going to be doing
the presentation. I actually have no problem. I have no problem while I'm presenting. You are sitting here and watching me, and you cross-examine me after I make a presentation that I sat and I prepared for. I'm willing to take questions on that. I anticipate
Dr.
questions.
Brown,
I'm willing to do that. But I have no interest in sitting there when you are making a presentation. I don't need to cross-examine you on the spot. I could do that in my presentation. If you want, we could splice all these videos together and call it a debate, and maybe we'll get more viewers because of that word, debate. Or if you want, we could actually start a new thread. We could coordinate. We want to choose a specific subject and maybe coordinate how often we'll be doing it or how long they should be. And maybe, like I said, if you want, you can be here to cross-examine me, or I can come to your place and you can cross-examine me when I make a presentation. I have no problem with that. That's it. If you feel that
y'all can never do that,
more beneficial, more educational, it's fine. A second issue that I would like to address. Dr. Brown, you suggested that I pull those
Dr.
videos
Brown.
That are titled unanswered. Because you feel that now you have answered the questions that I raised. Maybe not to my satisfaction, but you feel that you have answered them. Now we're going to
say that
if you did or didn't answer them. But for argument's sake, let's say that you did answer them. So why should I pull those videos? I think you ought to go down for the record that for years and years you left those questions unanswered.
Y'all can never say
that. And again, I'm not saying that. Audience considers that they deserve
Brown.
Answer. I'm leaving
Dr.
that
Brown.
Out to the audience. Then it should go down for the record that for all those years you left the truth seeker without answers to those questions. And the third non-issue that I would like to discuss, or distraction that I would like to discuss, you take issue with the fact that I called my written response to your five volumes comprehensive. You tell us that comprehensive, it would have to be thousands and thousands of pages. Well, I don't define comprehensive by the length of a book. I define comprehensive by
what
it's supposed to accomplish. Throughout the years, I received many questions on the basis of your book, and invariably, almost every time I can point back to my writing, and people are satisfied, people have read your book, people have read my writing.